welcome back to my channel. I'm Jessica Alexandria of Bahati Life. Thank you so much for tuning in. Today, I want to talk about this week ahead because it's just really interesting looking at the chart and then pairing it up with the cards and what's kind of been showing itself and revealing itself. And then also intuitively what I've been feeling. And I have to, of course, include my own personal experiences with this type of energy and hope that it makes sense to you and that it applies. So the first thing that I want to talk about, there's two major things that are going to be happening this week, and it's the fact that Mercury, the planet of communication and the planet of the way that we think about things or how we're able to think about things and process things, how we're able to articulate those thoughts, put them into words, the things that we write down, and also movable things such as little gears, technology, cameras, phones, those types of things. Finally, it's going to go direct after being, Mercury is finally going to go direct after being retrograde. So he's going to be going direct on the 6th, which is a Thursday, in the sign of Scorpio. So that's number one. That's a big thing that we need to talk about. Number two is the day right after that, we're going to have this new moon in Sagittarius. Sagittarius is the opposite of Gemini. Gemini is ruled by Mercury, so there's a lot of interesting dynamics that are falling within that that we're going to talk about. So those are two things. But the next thing that I'm seeing and that is being highlighted this week, and I'm not sure why this is or why it's I'm feeling kind of called to talk about this, is this element of confusion, of being directionless. In fact, when I sat down to meditate this morning and to think about, you know, what the energy is kind of looking like and what I can expect for this week and kind of open myself up to my angels and my guides to kind of give me any type of intuitive hunches in as far as things that I can apply for my life and things that I can share with you guys, the word that came through was listless. And when I first heard it, I was like, okay, fine. But then as I moved forward, the word kept coming through as I was pulling a chart. It's listless. And I know what the word listless means, but I had to Google it. I wanted to confirm what it was that I already knew. And the definition of listless was lacking energy and even direction. And it's the perfect word to describe the energy of this week. Now, it's going to be a little different for everyone. Not everybody's going to feel the impact of this in the same way or in the same area of their lives, and maybe you experience it in different extremes. But either way, you know, with Mars moving to the sign of Pisces, which has been happening for a few weeks now, it just seems like it's being really highlighted and heightened. The other thing that I'm seeing is the fact that the Sun on the 3rd, which is a Monday, the Sun and Mars are going to be squaring off almost exact on Monday. But just because it's exact on Monday doesn't mean that we don't feel it for the days following that and the days before that. Now, the Sun represents our life energy, our focus, our ego in a lot of ways, meaning like how what we understand about ourselves. And Mars is the sign of ambition, it's the planet of ambition and direction and how we work to accomplish, how we work to achieve. And Mars has been moving to the sign of Pisces. I love Pisces, don't get me wrong, I'm a Virgo, so Pisces is my opposite. And I respect all the signs, especially Pisces. But Pisces is, in a lot of ways, you know, it wants to rely on its intuition. It wants to rely on signs and signals, things that the rest of the world and the rest of the signs may not understand. But Pisces is so connected to it easily and effortlessly and naturally. And Mars wants to have this direct, you know, answer. It wants to have this direct course of action, this plan. And when he's moving through the sign of Pisces, again, which he's been doing for the last few weeks, it almost seems like, you know, it's hard to kind of lift things up, especially with Mercury being retrograde, especially with Venus was retrograde and the majority of the planets all of this year were retrograde, forcing you to kind of take these steps back. And now, you know, we're ending this year. And I just keep saying, you guys, you know what, we're going to fold this year up. Don't try to initiate things for December, even though Mercury is going to go direct on the 6th. I wouldn't try to initiate anything because even the energy around is still kind of like sorting itself and working itself out. There's so many things up in the air. And Mars moving through the sign of Pisces is a direct reflection of that. And again, Pisces is kind of like this, the metaphor that I use is, you know, this like dream warehouse, you know, or no, like a playhouse of sorts, where how things may seem or how things may appear is not actually how they are. And Mars doesn't really navigate through that very well. Mars, again, is like a bow and an arrow. You just kind of pull it back and shoot it forward. And when Mars is moving to the sign of Pisces, it just kind of seems like it's bumping its head into certain things. It's getting confused. It's getting clouded. It's getting distracted. It doesn't know if it's up or down or left or right. It has no idea, because that's the energy that Pisces brings. So when the Sun and Mars square off exact on Monday, what I'm seeing is it almost seems like this restless, high-wired, cranked-up energy. It almost wants to kind of provoke a fight. And I can understand, because it's like, what are we doing? Where are we going? Where am I headed? What's going on? What's happening? And the cosmos are not giving an answer, or other people are not going to give an answer, or you don't even have the answers within yourself. So it almost becomes like pushing. It almost becomes competitive. It almost is trying to demand, it's almost trying to force, and what ends up happening is that it ends up rubbing people the wrong way. It ends up becoming misunderstood in a lot of ways, especially with Mercury being retrograde. How you're thinking and what you're trying to say, they don't really align. So you may look back at it afterwards, especially if you're pushing for a resolution, or if you're pushing for a conclusion, or if you're pushing for an answer. You know, it just kind of, how you're verbalizing it and how you're trying to communicate may not come across clear to another person. They may not understand, or they may not have the answers themselves. So it ends up kind of collapsing. And that's what I was watching last week, was Venus sitting directly opposite Uranus. And for some people, again, this can create this extreme of a good, or the other opposite, the extreme of the bad, which is, you know, splitting, or someone just kind of pushing back and being like, you know, don't push me, don't force me to do anything that I don't want to do. Or when it comes to your spending, because Venus also rules your money and your values, when it comes to your spending, this is a sudden gain of finances or sudden loss of finances. Maybe it's also very impulsive. And that's one thing too that I want you guys to be aware of is, and I, as I'm saying this, you know, I was capitalizing on some Black Friday deals, but I really had to check and double check and triple check and quadruple check. And I know that sounds crazy, but I'm a Virgo. This is what we do anyways. We weigh all the pros and cons of everything. So I just felt myself kind of, you know, grappling between, do I want this? And, you know, I know the furniture pieces, because that's what I was shopping for. I was shopping for furniture. So I know what it is that I need for my space, but what is the aesthetic? What is the look? I still can't quite ground it and cement it right now. Of course, how could I when, you know, these planets are just kind of like so confused, so cloudy, so lost in the sauce, and that's what it is that we're kind of picking up on right now. Instead of me pushing and forcing and then later on regretting it, and just maybe I do get an end result, but it's not something that I'm going to love or that I'm going to want to keep around for very long. I'd rather save my money and wait for the right thing at the right time. Now, that's just an example for me in my life, but apply it to where it fits within your life. Instead of pushing for resolution or pushing for something to occur and to happen, maybe just kind of sit back. In fact, one of the cards that jumped out while I was, I don't know if you guys can see this. Okay, I'm gonna put it here. One of the cards that jumped out while I was preparing for this reading was the Hanged Man, and again, and the Magician, and the High Priestess. And we'll talk about all these cards in a minute. But with the Hanged Man, this is seeing things from a different perspective and maybe not being impulsive. In fact, the universe, if anything, kind of wants you to be suspended right now in order to see things from a different way and to let go of your need to control and let go of your need to kind of get to the end result, because outside of the fact that so many things are kind of falling into place and cementing themselves, but it's just like this act of like trust and faith that needs to happen on your behalf. And sometimes there's not a whole lot that you can do. Sorry about that, guys. I'm currently filming on my phone because I broke my camera while I was traveling. Of course, Mercury retrograde. I should have put a case on it and I didn't. So my camera's currently broken, so I have to film from my phone right now, and I got a phone call and it cut me off. But anyways, when it comes back to the Hanged Man, when this card appears, this is really like letting go of your need to control and to know what's going to happen next, or at least try to fight and exert energy into it, because it just seems like the energy that you push into it is so like it, not that it's wasted, but it almost is like going nowhere fast. And especially with the magician and the high priestess, the magician is all about creating and the ability to create, but something is being created, but it's through energy. It's not through actual exertion in a lot of ways. It's the intent. It's the energy of, or using the element of Mercury. And Mercury is, again, the mind, communication. The magician is ruled by the planet Mercury, because what we're doing is we're calling in, we're setting the intent, we're speaking life and energy into what it is that we want to manifest. And the magician is the beginning of that process of actual manifestation. It's alchemy. And I've been seeing a lot of the energy of alchemy within this week, which is, instead of exerting and pushing, work your magic, whatever that means for you. For some of you guys, that does actually mean candle magic. For some of you guys, that means working with the water, the ocean, the river. Those are some things that came through as I was, you know, meditating on, you know, this week ahead and the energy of this week. And also grounding yourself. So, or prayer, everyone's going to be different. Writing things down in your journal, writing things down in general, maybe putting them in a bottle or putting them in the ocean or whatever it is that is connected to the ocean, the river, the earth, even wind. But as far as fire right now, I don't see fire, the element of fire, outside of maybe working with candle magic a little bit, I don't see it being totally successful this week, because there's so much that is connected again with these oceans and these vibes and, you know, just almost like flowing with it and setting intention, calling it in by, you know, your mind, your words, writing it down, going to, I don't know if there's someone who's focusing on like a ritual focused on revolving around the ocean or water or the river or bath soaks, like a baptism of sorts. But either way, again, it's almost allowing yourself to float and kind of vibe with these energies, because the planets as a whole are really saying, you know, if you push, if you exert, there's nothing within the chart right now that is trying to push and exert energy into anything. It's more of floating into this abyss. And I think that that's why this word listless came through, which again was lacking energy and direction. It's not that you don't know where you're going. Maybe you don't, but it's kicking your feet up a little bit. And while you're floating there, allow the universe to kind of take you and buoy you and support you, which is the ultimate act of faith, because you don't know what's going to happen. You don't know where you're headed or how things are going to manifest or how things are going to reveal themselves and play out. But either way, you have to kick your feet up. You have to float for a little bit. And I'm seeing the energy of salt water and detox. In fact, these soaks during the new moon and all of this week, you better believe I'm going to be taking a bath every single night of this week, because I need that in my own life, is to just kind of kick back into detox and to relax. And instead of exerting energy and trying to strive to get to resolutions on certain things or to understand them or to push to a conclusion, it's more of, you know what, I'm going to kick my feet up and I'm going to allow the universe, the world, my angels, my guides, my spirit to kind of take me where I need to go. And I just kind of trust that, because I know I'm being protected and I need to float. Meanwhile, I am also seeing this need for knowing what it is that you want and knowing what it is that you deserve and what that life kind of looks like for you. In fact, there's a few cards that came through that just resonated so hard with me and made a lot of sense for this week. And one of them is the Ten of Cups, the second is the Ace of Pentacles, and the next one is the Six of Swords. Now, Ten of Cups, the way that these cards, you know, fell out, it tells the story. So I'm just going to tell you guys intuitively how it came. I'm not going to explain to you guys my process, because that's a totally new, another video. But with the Ten of Cups, this is, again, thinking about your personal happily ever after. Sometimes it can be a little exaggerated because it is the ideal, but either way, I want you guys to strive towards that. And I don't want you guys to compromise on that. And a part, when I say sacrifice, I don't want you guys to think like you have to sacrifice certain aspects of your dream or your vision that you have for yourself, especially when it comes to security and family and love and your ultimate happiness in this life. But what I mean by sacrifice, and you guys might want to revisit my video that I did last week about sacrifice, but when I say sacrifice and sacrificing, it's in this case, letting go of something, releasing something in order to help you to move into a space where you are stepping into your happily ever after. So if you have this vision for your life, and it's obvious that you guys are, we are moving in that direction with the Six of Swords, it's moving from these rough waters and this rough time into smoother sailing. But the boat can easily be tipped. We're not there yet. This person has only just got into that boat and moved forward, and there's too many things that can happen. A storm can come through. There could be a hole in the boat. The person could lose their direction, you know, maybe not know, but they're going in a way, but who knows at this point? We can't, you know, invest. We can't put the money into it, even though the potential is there. That's what this Ace of Pent is, especially with the Magician. The potential is there, but we haven't got to the ground yet. We haven't made it to where we're going, our end destination, especially now in December as we're folding this year up. Now, again, the people who are in this boat are totally at the mercy or under the guidance of the person who's steering the boat. So in a lot of ways, they are kind of hung up. They are kind of powerless in this. But they are saying what it is that they want. They're saying what it is that they need. And something has already kind of brought itself into momentum. So something has already started to move forward. They need patience. They need to moderate themselves. They need to be calm. They need to be cool. They also need to listen to their intuition and connect with their intuition and be guided before they react, before they jump. Because at this point, it's a very vulnerable space to be in. And that's the Hanged Man in general, is like, how vulnerable could you be? Like, you're hung up, you're strung up by your feet. Like, you don't get any more hung up by that. But what I can see and what I can, you know, promise is that if you follow this right, and if you take these steps, you know, proactively, and if you hear what it is that I'm saying, the end result is going to have promise to it. The Ace of Pentacles shows that there is something here that is worthy of investing in. There is something here that is of value. And not everybody is going to see that right away, but they don't have to, but they will eventually. At some point, it'll become clear to them. Maybe it'll be too late. Maybe it won't be too late. But at the end of the day, you have to see what it is that you are, what it is that you are able to do, what it is that you give. The beauty and the blessing of just being in your presence, and the energy that you give, and the diamond that you are, and you're creating right now. Focus on creating your life, and focus on your vision, focus on your intention, focus on manifesting, because that is what you can do in order to help you to navigate through these waters right now and get to the shore. Now, again, on the 5th, Sun squares Neptune. Again, it's this energy of just kind of like, I don't know why, but I'm kind of feeling like fear, but it comes from not knowing. It comes from not being able to see clearly. It comes from maybe even being deceived, lied to. Neptune in general, I don't mean to speak ill of any planet, but I, you know, you guys, I'm always going to tell you the truth. Neptune rules illusion and fantasy, and which is good because it brings romance into your life and beauty into your life, but it also rules deception and things not being what it is that they seem. Now again, when the Sun squares off with Neptune, this is a person who is not revealing the honest truth of who they are, or you not revealing the honest truth of who you are, or you not speaking your truth. Mercury moving through the sign of moving in, you know, Scorpio, although retrograde, the following day is going to then move direct. And that's when we're probably going to start seeing, I want to say around the full moon. So we have the new moon this week on the 7th, but around the full moon, that's when we're most likely going to start seeing these truths kind of revealing themselves that are happening around this week. So again, if someone's lying to you, if something is hidden from you, it will be revealed. I don't want to say that it's being, you know, it'll be blown out into the water this week. There's a potential for it, but I think that the answers will reveal itself later on around the 22nd to 23rd of December. That's when we start, you know, seeing things, and that's when we start to hear a conclusion, and it all is connected around this week. In the meantime, I really want you guys to ground yourself and to cement yourself and to, again, focus on what you are manifesting, what you want, your intention, and keeping that pure, because that's going to help to move you in the direction that you need to be versus you kind of wasting your time and, you know, things not being what they seem, and you trying to focus so much on your logic and focus on your ability to like piece things together and find a solution. Too many things are being clouded right now for you to even come to that, especially the planet Mercury ruling that ability to think straight, being retrograde, and the rest of the planets being like pushing and pushing, but not really knowing like where are we going. It's like, you know, a fire or something, and people are pushing in the woods, and there's this fire. You know, you don't know if you're going to the flames or if you're going away from them because everything is smoky. That's the energy of what we have right now. The 7th, we have the new moon in Sagittarius. And again, Sagittarius is all about seeing things from the bigger perspective, the larger perspective. It's about connecting with your inner wisdom, not what it is that you can learn, but what it is that you know within your heart and your soul and your spirit. What is true for you? Because that's what is kind of seeding itself and cementing itself for this new moon, and that's going to be on the 7th. And make sure that you're subscribed to the channel, because I'm going to be talking about Sagittarius, the Sagittarius new moon, in further detail, pulling cards for that and doing a full reading for that in my next video. All right, so that's again what it is that I see for you guys. This, you know, the same day with the new moon, Mars sits directly on top of Neptune. Things are again not what it is that they seem. You want to follow your intuition, you want to ground. Even though you're connected to the divine, even though you're connected to this higher source of peace and clarity, at the same time, you need to ground yourself and cement yourself. Just looking at this, there's so much like waves that I'm looking at. It's, again, I'm seeing the ocean, I'm seeing the river, I'm seeing illusion, fantasy, intention, and thinking about, you know, what it is that you want, setting the intention for that, and allowing that to kind of unfold versus you pushing and exerting. All right, so I hope that makes sense, you guys. Make sure that you're subscribed again to the YouTube channel, because I have plenty more videos where this came from. And if you need the detox soaps, I mean, if there's a great way for you to work with this energy, it's by working with charged energy soaks. If you need those, they're in my shop. If you want to make something of your own, then make sure that you're using really high quality essential oils and Epsom salts, or just salts in general, that are natural, as natural as possible, because you don't want anything artificial, you don't want fragrances or anything like that, you know, making things more dense for you. Believe it or not, these essential oils are, they have an energy to them, a vibration, but fragrance oils do not. They're too dense for that, and it's just too much going on in the cosmos right now that I don't want you guys bringing in dense energies at all, point blank, period. Okay? So, that being said, I love you guys so much. Thank you so much for tuning in, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!